Welcome to all of you. Today's our discussion topic is multiple pulse modulation. In last discussion, we have seen the single pulse modulation. Multiple pulse modulation is the extension to the single pulse modulation. In single pulse modulation, only single pulse is used per half cycle. But here in multiple pulse modulation, the number of pulses which are equidistant to each other are used per half cycle. Okay, the symmetrical equidistant pulses are generated with the help of the comparator and the trigger pulse generator. Okay, in the comparator, a triangular wave, which is nothing but a carrier wave of amplitude vc and the frequency equivalent to omega c, okay, and the adjustable square wave, which is nothing but the modulating signal, okay, with the amplitude is equivalent to Vr and the frequency is equivalent to f. Okay, these are compared in the comparator. The output of the comparator is provided to the trigger pulse generator. Okay, so here you can see one example here. This is the triangular wave. Okay, which is the carrier wave with the amplitude is equivalent to Vc and the frequency is equivalent to omega c. So this total duration for a single pulse is equivalent to 1 upon Fc. And this is a reference square wave with the amplitude is equivalent to Vr and the frequency is equivalent to f. So this total duration is equivalent to 1 upon f. This total duration is equal to 1 upon f here. Okay, so that in between 0 to pi, okay, here this duration is 1 upon 2f. Okay, now how to generate here or how to find out the number of pulses generated per half cycle. Okay, so the number of pulses generated per half cycle are calculated by using the formula n is equivalent to length of the half cycle. Of square reference wave divided by width of one cycle of triangular wave. Now in this example here, n is equivalent to length of half cycle of square reference wave, which is equivalent to 1 upon fc, 1 upon 2f, okay, divided by width of one cycle of triangular wave, which is equivalent to 1 upon fc. So n will become here equivalent to fc divided by 2 times f, or we can say this is equivalent to omega c divided by 2 times omega. Okay, now in this example here, okay, length of half cycle of square reference wave is, how much it is? It is equivalent to, okay, we can say this 1 upon 2f is equivalent to pi, and width of one cycle of triangular wave, it is 1 upon fc, which is equal to pi by 4. Okay, so replacing these values here, we are getting okay, fc is equivalent to pi by 4, okay, multiplied by 1 upon 2f, which is equivalent to 1 upon 2f is equivalent to 5. Replacing these values, you are getting 4 by pi multiplied by pi, which is equivalent to 4. So n will become equivalent to 4 here. Okay, so 4 number of pulses gets generated at the output. Okay, so see here, we can observe here that okay, when the triangular wave amplitude is greater than that of the Vr reference square wave, okay, at that time the trigger pulse gets generated. Okay, and this trigger pulse is provided to turn on the SCR. Okay, the duration for which the carrier wave is greater than that of the reference wave, okay, your SCR is in on condition. So you are getting output at the inverter. Okay, at the output of inverter. Okay, Okay, so here for wherever there is an intersection in between these two waves, okay, so the comparator generates the pulses which are the comparator output is high, okay, and so that the trigger pulses are generated here to turn on the SCRs. Okay, so we can observe here the methodology or the one triangular wave where the output pulses or how the output pulses are get generated for this duration. Okay, so we can observe here this duration is equivalent to x. Okay, the pulse width is equivalent to 2d divided by n. This total duration is nothing but 1 upon fc. Okay, this total duration is equivalent to 1 upon fc. So in this case it is equivalent to pi by 4. Okay, so here this is nothing but the number of pulses generated within the half cycle. The number n should be, the number n should always be an integer. The pulse height of the reference wave of or the modulating wave can be controlled within the range in between, okay, 0 to Vc. Okay, that means the pulse height of this reference wave should not exceed than that of the Vc. It should be in between 0 to Vc only. Okay, it should be in between 0 to Vc only. Okay, it should not get exceeded. Okay, the pulse width is given by 2d divided by n. Okay, pulse width here is given by 2d divided by n, and it is varied in between the range 5 by n, should not get excess than that of the 5 by n. This total duration is nothing but 5 by n. Okay, and this is the pulse width, so it should not get excess than that of the 0 to 5 by n. Okay, this is 5 by n and this is 0. Okay, this pulse width should not get excess than that of the 5 by n. By varying the amplitude of VR, okay, this is nothing but our VR and this is nothing but our VC. By varying the height of the reference square wave, that means by varying the value of VR, we can vary the pulse width 2d divided by n, and it should not exceed than that of the pi by n. Okay, so this is about the output wave generated at the output side. Okay, now here we can find out the value of x. Okay, so how to find out the value of x here? Okay, the general equation for the pulse width is given as 2d divided by n is equivalent to pi by n minus 2 times x. This total duration is pi by n. Okay, and here this x plus this x, 2x. Okay, when 2x is subtracted from pi by n, we are getting the pulse width, that is 2d divided by n. Okay, so if you observe these two triangles here, this first triangle, okay, and this second triangle, we can say that here this is our first triangle. Okay, and this one is our second triangle. By observing these two triangles, we can say that, okay, VC divided by, okay, this is our VC, VC divided by, okay, this total duration is pi by n. So this duration is pi by 2n, which is equivalent to, okay, VR divided by x. Okay, so it is Vc divided by pi by 2n is equivalent to Vr divided by x. Okay, so simplifying this, we have x is equivalent to pi by 2n into Vr divided by Vc. Okay, now replacing this value of x in our equation of pulse width, it is 2d divided by n, we are getting 2d divided by n is equivalent to pi by n minus pi by n into Vr divided by Vc, okay, which is equivalent to 1 minus Vr divided by Vc into pi by n. Okay, so this is the equation of pulse width. 2d divided by n is equivalent to 1 minus vf divided by vc into pi by n. Okay, so by using this equation, we can find out the pulse width of the output signal. Okay, so here we have taken for reference 4 pulses within a half cycle. Okay, now we are going to see the Fourier series analysis of this multiple pulse modulation. Okay, so for Fourier series analysis here we are considering, okay, for simplicity we are considering here only 2 pulses, okay, get generated at the output. Okay, so within this duration from 0 to pi, okay, these 2 pulses get generated, each having the pulse width is equivalent to d. Okay, this total duration we consider it is equivalent to gamma. Okay, so here the starting point of this pulse, first pulse, is equivalent to gamma plus d by 2. The starting point is equivalent to gamma minus d by 2, while the end point is equivalent to gamma plus d by 2. Okay, so the pulse ends at the duration gamma plus d by 2. Okay, so here the for simplicity we have considered only 1 pulse here. Okay, this total duration we can say that it is equivalent to theta 1, and this duration of half of the pulse is considered as theta 2. Okay, so we will see the Fourier pulse analysis of our pulse width, multiple pulse width modulation. The Fourier series analysis of the pulse width modulation. So we start with the analysis here. Okay, the Fourier series constants are given as An is equivalent to, okay, 2 by pi integral from 0 to pi V out sin n omega t into d omega t. Okay, which is equivalent to 2 by pi integral from the starting limit is gamma minus d by 2, end limit is gamma plus d by 2. Okay, so it is equivalent to 2 times Vs into sin n omega t d omega t. So why we have taken 2 here? Okay, within a half cycle 2 pulses get generated, so here we have multiplied the equation with 2. Okay, so here after solving this we are getting An is equivalent to 4 Vs divided by n pi. Okay, integral of sin n omega t is cos n omega t. The upper and lower limits are gamma minus d by 2, gamma plus d by 2. Okay, so after replacing the limits and solving for this interval, we are getting An is equivalent to a time Vs divided by n pi into sin of n gamma into sin of n d divided by 2. Okay, as this signal or this pulse or this wave is symmetrical, so he and equidistant to each other, the component bn is equivalent to 0 again. Okay, so the output voltage is given as v out is equivalent to summation from n is equivalent to 1 comma 3 comma 5 and so on up to infinity 8 vs divided by n pi into sin of n gamma into sin of n d divided by 2 into sin n omega t. Okay, this is the output voltage equation. Okay, this is the output voltage equation here. Okay, the amplitude of nth harmonic is given as Vn is equivalent to 8 Vs divided by n pi to sin n gamma into sin n d divided by 2. Okay, so this was the amplitude of nth harmonic. The magnitude Vn is dependent upon the value of gamma and the d by 2, okay, or d. When gamma becomes equivalent to pi by n, or the value of d becomes equivalent to 2 pi by n, the nth harmonic gets eliminated from the output voltage, because at that time either this term becomes equivalent to 0 or this term becomes equivalent to 0, so that nth harmonic gets eliminated from the output voltage. Okay, now here for the n pulses per half cycle, there are n plus 1 interleaving equidistant spaces. Okay, here n plus 1 equidistant interleaving spaces, each of width is equivalent to theta 1. Okay, so the total width of these n plus 1 equidistant spaces becomes equivalent to, okay, it is equivalent to n plus 1 multiplied by theta 1. Okay, so here in this case, this is theta 1. So theta 1, this is the theta 1. So 1, 2 and 3, 3 equidistant pulses will be there. Okay, so it is equivalent to pi minus width of the n pulses. Okay, so total duration minus width of the total n pulses. So here it will be pi minus 2 times d. Okay, so it will becomes pi minus width of the n pulses. 2 pulses we have considered here. So it is pi minus 2 times d. Okay, pi minus 2d here. Okay, so this is nothing but the total width of the n plus 1 equidistant spaces. Okay, so here we can say n plus 1 into theta 1 is equivalent to pi minus 2d. Okay, so from this we can find out the value of theta 1, which is equal to pi minus 2d divided by n plus 1. Okay, this is the equation for theta 1. Okay, that is nothing but this space. Okay, now what is theta 2? Theta 2 we can observe here. This is half of the pulse width. Okay, so total pulse width is nothing but d by 2d by n. Okay, so 2d by n, the whole divided by 2. So it will become equivalent to d by n. Okay, now we can say the gamma value is nothing but theta 1 plus theta 2. Okay, so for this, gamma is equivalent to theta 1 plus theta 2. So replacing the values of theta 1 and theta 2, we can see gamma is equivalent to pi minus 2d divided by n plus 1 plus d by n. Okay, so by using this equation, we can find out the gamma value. So here in this case, what it is? Okay, here in this case, okay, gamma value is equivalent to, okay, we will consider that the pulse width is equivalent to, okay, 2d is equivalent to 72 degree. Okay, pulse width we are considering here, it is equivalent to 72 degree. Okay, so here d will become equivalent to 36 degree. Okay, so replacing these values, we can find out the gamma. Gamma is equivalent to pi minus 2 times d divided by n plus 1 plus d by n. Replace these values. So it is 180 degree minus 2 times 36 degree divided by n plus 1. In this case, 2 pulses get generated. So n is equivalent to 2 here. Okay, so it is 3 plus d is nothing but 36 divided by 2. Okay, so after solving this, gamma value is equivalent to 54 degree. Okay, so here it is 54 degree. Okay, now replacing these values, we can find out the amplitude of the output voltage waveform. Okay, so the fundamental, the value of peak fundamental component is given as VOM is equivalent to, okay, A divided by VS divided by pi. Okay, the output value of fundamental component is nothing but, okay, so fundamental harmonic is given by VO1M is equivalent to 8VS divided by pi. Okay, N is equivalent to, small n is equivalent to 1 for, sorry, small n is equivalent to 1 for fundamental component. So it will be equivalent to VO1, if m is equivalent to 8 Vs divided by pi into sine of n gamma into sine of nd divided by 2. We have seen this equation of mu nm. Okay, so here it is equivalent to, for n is equivalent to 1, we have the equation 8 vs divided by pi into sine of gamma into sine d by 2. Okay, so here by using this equation we can find out 8 vs divided by pi into sine of, what is the value of gamma? It is 54 multiplied by sine of d by 2. So 36 divided by 2, that is 18 degree. Okay, so after solving this, we have BOM is equivalent to, this value becomes equivalent to 0.637 Vs. Okay, so in single pulse modulation, it is observed that this value VO1M is equivalent to, it is equivalent to 0.7484 Vs. Okay, so here the amplitude of fundamental component gate decreased in case of multiple pulse modulation. Okay, so we can say that the fundamental component of output voltage is lower, which is equivalent to 0.637 Vs in case of multiple pulse modulation or two pulse modulation as compared to the single pulse modulation, where it is equivalent to 0.7484 Vs. Okay, so for large values of pulses per half cycle, the amplitude of lower order harmonics gets reduced, but those of some higher or hard order harmonics gets increased. But this is not the disadvantage of multiple pulse modulation, because the higher order harmonics can be easily filtered out. Okay, so this is all about the multiple pulse modulation and its Fourier series analysis. Okay, in the same way, we are going to see the sinusoidal pulse modulation. Okay, in case of sinusoidal pulse modulation, it is similar to that of the multiple pulse modulation, but here, in the comparator, along with the carrier signal, which is a triangular wave of amplitude Vc, we are going to compare the sinusoidal wave with amplitude is equivalent to Vr instead of a square wave. Okay, so here the sine wave has the amplitude is equivalent to Vr, and the carrier wave has the amplitude is equivalent to Vc. And these are the output waveforms of a sinusoidal pulse modulation. Okay, in the comparator, these two signals are compared together, triangular wave Vc and sinusoidal wave with Vr, amplitude Vr. These are compared together. Okay, when the sinusoidal reference signal has amplitude greater than that of the triangular wave, the trigger pulses get generated at the output of comparator output is high, so that the trigger pulses get generated in trigger pulse generator, which provides the trigger pulses to turn on the SCRs. Okay, so these are the outputs of our sinusoidal pulse width modulation. Okay, in case of square pulse modulation or square pulse modulation, the width of each output pulse is equal, but here in case of sinusoidal pulse modulation, the width of the output pulses, they are comparable to the duration for which our comparator is the comparator output is high. Okay, so it is in proportion with that output. The ratio of the reference voltage Vr and the carrier voltage Vc is known as the modulation index. The modulation index should not exceed than that of the 1. Okay, so Vr divided by Vc should be always less than equivalent to 1. Okay, this modulation index controls the output waveform of the inverter. The magnitude of the fundamental component of output voltage is proportional to the modulation index, and the modulation index should not be more than that of the unity. Okay, the harmonic analysis of modulated output voltage wave is gives the following features. Okay, for the MI less than 1, for the modulation index less than 1 here, okay, the largest harmonic output, the largest harmonic amplitudes in the output voltage are associated with the harmonic FC divided by F plus minus 1, or it will be 2n plus minus 1, where n is the number of pulses per half cycle. By increasing the number of cycles per pulses, the order of dominant harmonic frequency can be raised, as in case of the multiple pulse modulation, which can be then be filtered out easily. It is observed that as n is increased, here the order of significant harmonic increases and the filtering requirements are less here. Okay, but that is, filtering requirements means filters are minimized here, but higher value of n increases the switching frequency of the thyristors. Okay, so as the switching frequency of thyristor increases, so the more switching losses will be there, and therefore the inverter efficiency gets decreased. Okay, so that we have to make a compromise between the filtering requirements and the inverter efficiency. Okay, here if the modulation index is greater than 1, then what will happen? Okay, for modulation index MI greater than 1, then what will happen here? For modulation index greater than 1, here the VR is greater than that of the VC. Okay, so what will happen here for this? Okay, lower order harmonics appears in the output voltage. Okay, and the pulse width is no longer the sinusoidal function of the angular position of the pulses. Okay, as it is greater than that of your output, as VR is greater than that of the triangular wave. Okay, always your output is high, and the number of pulses, the pulse width of the generated output is not the function of a sinusoidal modulating signal. Okay, so this is all about the sinusoidal pulse modulation. Okay, so in previous discussion we have discussed about the single pulse modulation, and in today's discussion we have discussed about the multiple pulse modulation as well as the sinusoidal pulse modulation. Okay, so this is the pulse width modulation technique of the inverter. Thank you.